Alright guys, welcome to the video. Where are we at?
I don't know, you'll have to stick around after that intro to find out. Roll that intro. I just wanna see the light. Okay, so we are at St. Maarten. This is our second stop on our Royal Caribbean cruise. Today we're going to be doing the plane spotting at Maho Beach. If you don't know what that is, it's the planes fly really close to the beach here in the airport when they're landing. It's quite the experience we've heard and seen, so we shall see. First, I'll show you some views from the ship, though. It's pretty nice. You can kind of see it behind us, but we'll show you a little bit better here in a second. This is St. Maarten. This is like the downtown area right here. I can't remember what the beach is called, but it's a famous beach here. It goes from all the way here, all the way over there. We have a 40-minute ride there, and then we don't know exactly what we're doing, but we're going to watch some planes land over our head. So, are you excited, Devin?
Yeah.
Let's get into it. We're heading to the bus now. This port's quite busy today. Looks like we got some shots and stuff down here, right at the port. Looks like we have restrooms here too, which is nice, right at the bus stop.
When my mom was growing up, all here was water. All here was water that we're driving on, the filling over 500 acres of the body of water. And to your right-hand side, behind the trees, you can see the remaining of the body of water. So that body of water is called a great salt pond. So that's a salt pond. That's where we used to pick salt in the olden days. So Christopher Columbus arrived down here after the Arawak Indians in 1493. And he renamed our island after a bishop in Spain, St. Maarten of Tours. And that's how we got the name St. Maarten on the map. 1644, we went to a Dutch commander, came down here, tried to colonize the islands. But while he was hoisting his flag, the Spanish, they shot him down with a cannonball and blew off his right leg. He had to have it amputated and fixed up, and he later on became the first governor over there, better known as Peg Leg Pete in New York. The Spanish, they took over the island, and they was not interested in the salt pans, they was interested in gold, but they did not find any gold, so then they lost interest in the island and withdrew their forces back to Spain. This allowed once again the French and the Dutch to return back here on the island of St. Maarten, and they share the island by a race. So the French side is bigger than the Dutch side. The French side is 21 square miles, the Dutch side is 16 square miles. And we have been living here peacefully for the past 365 years together, and by God's grace we intend to keep it that way. Both sides of the island run independently of their own sources. On the French side, they're under the direct rule of France. And there they have a president who on the French side of St. Maarten. On the Dutch side, we are a country in the Kingdom of Holland and have been appointed a governor to run the Dutch side of St. Maarten. The sports that we enjoy here at St. Maarten is baseball, basketball, football, soccer, and also cricket. And also a hand-play game of dominoes. So we're going down to Maho. I haven't been there for a whole week, but this is the only beach on the island that does disappear and reappear whenever she feels like. How was it yesterday, Otis? The beach was there? Yeah, the beach was there. Because sometimes you have a beautiful beach, come down there the next morning, only rocks. Here we have the mega yacht. We have the lift bridge. This bridge was built in 1950. Yes, and this bridge opened up 3-4 times a day. We're going to be having Heineken Regatta in the next week, so down here is going to be a real, real crazy house. And this was built in 2013, the swing bridge. It swings open. Yes.
All right, guys, we made it to the drop-off spot. We're almost to the beach. The airport's like right there. So, hopefully we had a little bit of a good view on the way over. We'll check the rest of this out in just a second.
Looks like we got some shopping, some restaurants. Definitely got the tiki bar vibe going here. Everyone floating in the water kind of makes sense. We'll say the water is like super blue. Nice Caribbean vibes down here.
Plane coming in, guys.
That's a big boy. Pretty high shot in your stomach.
Kind of like private jet time, but you know, still cool. I will say, probably if you plan on doing this, maybe plan on swimming. But the beach is like super crowded, so I mean, I get it, popular spot, but just something to be aware of. Like, there's people, like all the lounge chairs are already taken up, so we're kind of posted up here on the concrete wall. So anyway, seems like all the small planes are taking off right now.
Here comes one little prop plane in.
We ended up over here in the Sandbar. The main area over by the beach is like so packed. As you can see, like from here, this is just right next door and it's pretty open. The only downside is we can't see the planes landing, which we just kind of missed one. Fail! But hopefully we'll catch a couple more here this afternoon.
What have you thought of this so far, Beth?
I think the beach is very crowded. It's just pretty much people to people, and they expect you to just stand in the beach and watch. And there's a very little, the beach is a lot smaller than I expected it to be.
Yeah, I agree. It's been fun, but I don't know if I'd do this again. I'm kind of like Ordinary Adventures here. I did it once, I don't have to do it again. There's a big plane landing. I don't know if we're going to catch it. Oh no. We're up here waiting again. This should be a United flight, according to flight radar.
You guys probably can't even see him yet. There's like a little dot right here.
That was awesome. If you ever come plane spotting at Maho Beach, you gotta come over to the Sandbar. If you're like heading to the main entrance, it's on the left. This place is amazing. It's straight across the road from the casino, which is right here.
Pizza priced food, really good portion size, tastes really good, amazing drinks. And the service is slow, but—
we're on island time.
But as long as you don't have anywhere you gotta be, definitely come over here and check it out.
We found this really helpful because the other restaurant was busy. There was really tons of people in there, so it seems like the planes are taking off now instead of landing. So let's go see if we can see any.
Another plane is right there.
Oh yeah, that was cool. When the breeze blows, it feels good, but oof. No shade.
The chairs cost $20 for a chair and an umbrella. Just to look at. Two chairs and an umbrella.
Here. That one was awesome. All right, we got some more action. We have one taking off, getting ready to take off, and one landing. Like 2 to 3 people who lost their hats down there. The whole crowd got blown back. It's hilarious. I think that's going to wrap it up for us, though, here at Maho Beach. Heading back to the bus now.
Now, right here in St. Maarten, you can island hop to our neighboring islands. We have Anguilla, which is not too far away. Anguilla is just a 30-minute boat ride. You can take a ferry from down here by the airport, or Simpson Bay, or Marigold, or Grappies Marina. And that's about between $60 to $70 round trip to the British island of Anguilla. Anguilla is where you have Janet Jackson and Chuck Norris have their own private homes over there separately. So right here to your left, you can take the ferries from this location. So if you look to your right, you can see Sabre out there in the water. It's a sleeping volcano. And that's where the original King Kong was filmed in the 1940s. Yes. We have 6 cruise ships in town today. We are the 2nd busiest port in the Caribbean, right after St. Thomas. The most cruise ship we ever had on a single day is a 9 cruise ship day. So here's your cruise ship. So just in case you didn't have enough beach time, there's another beach right there close by. Here we have an open spot. We lost one of our hotels, and it was right here, and I see they're busy cleaning up to start rebuilding again. And that was also a 5-star. This was a sister of the one down by the airport.
All right, guys, plane spotting at Maho Beach. I hope you liked that video. What did you think of the tour in general, Beth?
One, there were way too many people there. There were 6 large cruise ships in port today, and I'm thinking a good portion of those people were at that beach.
It felt like it for sure.
Overall, it's a very small beach area that you can actually sit in, and half of that area they have like pretty much set up for beach chairs that you can rent, which were already filled by the time we got there. Pretty much, we just had to sit on a wall that we could find space on and just bake.
Yeah, so I didn't see the actual board. I'm sure it was by the bar somewhere. We didn't really see that for the actual planes landing and stuff. I had the flight radar app, and I just pulled that up so you could see what was landing. So do that before you go to the beach, or, you know, I try to find the board. Overall, I did like the bus ride. I thought our tour guide kept it interesting. Her knowledge of the island as we were going through. I think we did hit a good high note with our lunch we had.
The bar and restaurant that's right there next to Maho Beach was packed. Like, there was not an empty seat to be found, and most of the people, once they got a seat, they weren't leaving.
They camped out the whole time, I guarantee.
To me, the highlight of the afternoon was lunch, and that was a restaurant we found on our own, and it was not included in the tour.
Nope, it was right next to the main location. Okay, so the restaurant was
Sandbar and Kitchen by the Ocean. I do have to say, with that place, lunch was good, very filling, nice large portions.
Oh, yeah.
Devin got the bacon egg cheeseburger, Eric got the blue burger, I got 3 steak tacos, and they were overflowing. I also have to say, you know, the guys each got 2 Cokes each, plus I got a bottle of water and a fruit punch.
And they got a margarita.
And he got a margarita. My fruit punch seemed to be homemade. It didn't seem like it was, you know, just jug fruit punch. Very good. And total for our lunch was like $73, which I really didn't think was too bad.
I thought that was really good, especially, as you know, captive audience, right? They can charge pretty much whatever they want. So I thought that was pretty reasonable for a tourist
tourist trap, if you will.
But other than that, I think that was, we could only, you know, sit out there and watch the planes for so long before we needed shade.
Yeah.
And there was plenty of shade and plenty of tables to be had at the place we chose lunch. Like I said, service was a little slow, but we didn't have anywhere we had to be, so we were fine with that.
Yeah, she even turned a fan on for us, so pointed it right at Beth. So that was kind of nice. So we really did enjoy that part, and we did kind of buy, Devin got a hat, and I got a couple of magnets.
Yeah, the merch shop that was there by Maho Beach was very overpriced.
Yes.
Devin's hat was $40, and the magnets Eric got were $6 a piece.
Well, I think the one was $6 and one was $3, but yeah. So, I mean, obviously, tourist trap, you're paying tourist prices.
It was neat to see once. I don't know that I would ever do it again.
Yeah, I don't think this is a tour that, as Ordinary Adventures put it, we would need to do again. We've done it once. It's fun.
And even the people that were getting into the water, some people were watching the planes from the water. There are a lot of waves, especially with the planes coming in, and there's a very steep
entry into the water.
Yes, and exit from the water. And if you're not careful, you can kind of get pushed up against the beach in the water. So, really not my kind of thing.
Yeah, so it was fun. We're glad we did it, especially for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, why don't you go ahead and smash that like button. If you're new here, you want to follow along, we have some more videos coming out of this trip. Click that subscribe button.
If you've ever done this tour before or ever been done plane spotting at Maho Beach, leave us a comment and let us know what you thought of it.
Yeah, let us know if you did a tour through the cruise line or you just drove yourself there. Also, if you'd like to support the channel, we do have a coffee page. We'll throw it up here. It's just a virtual tip. Kind of helps keep this train on the tracks, as Carpetbagger says. We also do have merch. Best wearing the merch. I'm wearing my rash guard still from today. But we do have merch shelf. It should be right below this video. You can pick up swag from this trip if you want to. It helps support the channel that way. We really would appreciate it. Other than that, guys, we really enjoyed making this video for you. It was fun, and we had a great day, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching. Peace and love.